Over the years, we've developed so many new technologies for the Olympics, especially after the war. In fact, in 48 in London, when the Olympics were here last time, is that the birth of modern timekeeping. So since then, you know, the photo finish, the photoelectric cells, all the technology. And what we do is try to follow what the federations want and what the athletes want. So we don't go to them with our proposals. We listen to what they want and we try to do it as best we can. This year we have a new starting block for the athletics and a new quantum timer that will be very useful for different events like swimming and fencing and sailing.
People around the world are just fascinated about how you get it down just to like, that less than a split second, that kind of a timing. Just explain to us, what exactly are photocells and quantum timing?
Actual timing is one thing, but the backup systems are so important because anything can go wrong, and that's where the most effort is given. You know, it is possible, there are certain cameras that take, let's 2,000 shots a second, you know, to really define certain very close calls. So it's an ongoing process. You know, the company's been doing it for 80 years, since 1932. We do events all around the world outside of the Olympics, so it's all part of our, really, it's really our job to do this.
What is the most challenging part of doing this and being so involved in making sure that the times aren't messed up?
Well, by having the best people, the most dedicated people, the best equipment. And, you know, it's like every life, if you prepare the best you can, anything can happen anytime, but this is our legacy has been over the years, and I think we're pretty confident that Omega can deliver. And I think the IOC also confident, that's why we have continued our relationship with them, and we have until 2020 now.
Tell us a little bit about this.
Every Olympics, it's been like a tradition that there's a countdown to the opening ceremony, and obviously we took the London Olympic emblem, and we developed this. We got fantastic chance to be able to put it in an iconic area like Trafalgar Square, which is not easy to, you know, to have something there on a permanent basis.
And just a last question, perhaps the most important. Do you make it everywhere on time?
I try to. I try to. I think this is, you know, time is something you cannot change. It's there. So if you can manage it, sometimes, you know, I arrive in meetings late because of traffic or what have you, but I try to be on time. It's a very important aspect.